So yesterday I showed you how you can make typing a little easier on the iPad by splitting the keyboard and moving it from the bottom of the screen. Well, you don't have those options on an iPhone, and for the most part you don't need them because the device itself is smaller and easier to reach all the keys wherever they are on the screen. But there are some options to make the keyboard a little easier to type on depending upon what you're comfortable with. So here I am in Notes, and I'm on an iPhone 10, so things are going to look a little bit different if you're on, say, an iPhone 6, 7, 8 or 6, 7, 8 Plus. But in this case, if you look at the keyboard, you can see there's that little keyboard change button. It's a little globe at the bottom left. And this allows you to switch keyboards. But if you tap and hold it, you could see you get things like keyboard settings and then the keyboards I have installed. Then at the bottom, you have the option to switch to one-handed keyboards. So notice there are three options there. The middle one is the one that's selected, and that's the standard keyboard. I can select the one on the left, and when I do that, you can see the keyboard moves. All the keys move a little bit to the left. So now they're a little more reachable by my thumb on the left side of my iPhone. And notice that there is a little arrow thing there at the right side. If I tap that, you can see it automatically expands to put the keyboard across the entire screen again. I could actually just select it here and then do the same thing again. Select it again and select the middle. And there's also the one on the right depending upon how you like holding your iPhone. And then you can actually tap that little arrow there on the left side to expand the keyboard. You can also find this in the Settings app, although there's really no advantage to choosing it there. A quick way to get to the Settings app is to actually use the keyboard settings option here. But you can go in through the regular Settings app as well and then look for keyboards. And here you can turn one-handed keyboard off, left, or right. But it's basically the same as turning it on if you know using the keyboard just at the bottom here. Like that. Now these are much more useful on the plus size iPhone, so the 6, 7, and 8 Plus. The screen there is just too big for most people to be able to use their thumb if they're holding the iPhone with one hand and reach the opposite side of the keyboard. So I'm holding with my left hand now, and I really can't reach the O, the P, the L, or even the K very comfortably with my thumb. But I can tap the keyboard change button, which in this case is the little smiley face because I only have the emoji keyboard installed here, and I can choose one of these other ones. And you can see now it cuts off a good 20, maybe 25% of the space there, really condensing the keyboard and making it much easier to reach all of the keys with my thumb. And likewise, if you're holding the phone with your other hand too, it's so useful here on the plus size screens, and definitely something you want to look into using if you need to type out a bunch of text while holding the phone, especially with one hand. Thank you.